Today we will see some basic differences between an induction motor and synchronous motor. So this is the most commonly asked interview questions for the electrical engineers. So stay tuned till the end of this video. So first difference is based on the working principle. The synchronous motor works on the principle of magnetic locking. It means that there are two magnetic fields exist in the synchronous motor, one on the stator and the other on the rotor, and the rotor field chases the magnetic field of the stator, due to which the rotor rotates at the speed of synchronous speed with the stator. Whereas the induction motor works on the principle of electromagnetic induction. It means that whenever there is a changing magnetic field and that changing magnetic field links with a coil or a conductor, an EMF is induced in the conductor which results in a flow of electric current, and due to this it experiences a force in the presence of the magnetic field, and due to which the rotor rotates in the presence of the magnetic field produced in the stator. Another difference is based on the speed of the motor. In synchronous motor, the speed of the rotor is equal to the speed of the rotation of the magnetic field produced in the stator. So the synchronous speed, which is the speed of the rotation of the magnetic field in the stator, is equal to the rotor mechanical speed. Therefore, the net slip, which is the difference between the two speeds, is equal to zero. And the synchronous motor is also called the constant speed motor. Whereas in the induction motor, the rotor speed is less than the synchronous speed, and this is called the slip, and the value of the slip is always between 0 to 1. At standstill, when the rotor does not rotate, the slip is maximum, which is equal to 1, and at maximum speed, the value of the slip is very low, but it will never be equal to zero, because both speeds cannot be equal in induction motor. And induction motor is also a variable speed motor. You can vary the speed of the motor by using variable frequency drives. The third difference is based on the excitation method or the starting method of this motor. In the synchronous motor, it requires a DC excitation system or the prime mover to start the motor. So there are two different supplies needed in the synchronous motor to start this motor. The first is the three-phase AC supply on the stator, whereas we provide a DC supply on the rotor. So since two supplies are required in this motor, this is called doubly excited motor. Whereas the induction motor can easily start whenever we supply the power to the stator without exciting the rotor. So we only need three-phase AC supply on the stator. So there are two types of rotor. First is the squirrel cage and the other is the wound type rotor. Then comes the another difference, and this is based on the power factor. The power factor is the angle between the current and the voltage. The synchronous motor operates normally at unity or 0.8 leading power factor, and we can also control the power factor of this motor from lagging to leading by varying the DC excitation. Also, the overexcited synchronous motors operate at leading power factor, and they are used for the power factor correction. Whereas the induction motor only operates at a lagging power factor. The final difference is based on the efficiency and the cost of the motor. The synchronous motor is more power efficient due to its leading or unity power factor. The efficiency of these motors are normally above 90%. The synchronous motor are more costly as compared to the induction motor. Whereas the induction motors are considered to be less efficient as compared to the synchronous motor, and the efficiency is ranging between 80% to the 90%, and these motors are cheaper than the synchronous motor. I hope you get the basic idea of the differences between these two types of motor. For more interesting videos, stay tuned and don't forget to subscribe our channel. Thank you for watching.